Now let us start discussing them in detail one by one. The other day we were discussing that the presence of noise definitely cannot be avoided. Noise sickness cannot be avoided. So noise is inherent. You can only devise methods to reduce it, but cannot be totally eliminated. Because it cannot be totally eliminated, so what we do is we devise methods, you know, to overcome these kind of methods. So now what is it that we are talking about is the next one, the parity check. So when you are talking about the parity check, a parity can be either odd or even. It can be odd parity or an even parity. So a parity bit is added to every data unit so that the total number of ones including the parity bit, you know, it becomes even for even parity or odd for odd parity check. So there is a simple algorithm here. This is a sender, this is a receiver. So what does a sender do? Sender is sending the information, that is data. This is the data that is being sent by the transmitter or the sender. So now calculate the parity bit. How many number of ones are there in this? There are 1, 2, 3 ones are there. So that means it is odd. So before an error is detected and error is corrected, we have to decide, are we going for even parity or odd parity? That pre-condition has to be put. So in this case, the data is having three number of ones which is odd. Calculate the parity bit. If you are thinking that you go for even parity, and since the number of ones is odd here, you add one extra bit, and that extra bit what you are adding is 1 to make it even. That means you are pre-assuming that it is an even parity type of communication. Now this data is sent through a transmission medium, and we call this transmission medium in the electronic communication, we call this as a channel. So it is sent through a channel having enough bandwidth. It can be atmosphere, any communication channel. It is sent through that and is now sent to a receiver. So you have a sender block here and a receiver block here. So now what happens in the receiver block? Once it goes through the transmission medium, it reaches this. Now count the number of bits. So when you send a good number of bits from the sender, when it reaches the receiver, you again do the process of counting. Now, since you assume this to be an even parity, you are checking for whether the number of ones are even. If the number of ones happen to be even, if the number of ones are even, then what are you doing? You are, if it is yes, drop the parity bit and accept the data. If it is no, that means it is not even, you have to reject the data and ask. You can either ask the sender to retransmit. There are mechanisms in which this can be even corrected. So either you ask the sender to retransmit it or make the correction. So this is the simplest of all the mechanisms, and we call this as a parity check. Next, here, how do you say, how do you make sure what you send is correct or not? So now there are again two blocks here. One is called the sender, the other one is called the receiver. Now the data that you are sending is here. It's having how many bits? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, 16. This is the number of bits that you are doing. And you are adding extra bits here, and these extra bits are something which is extra, they may not be required later on, therefore they are referred to as redundant bits. Redundant is something which is not required, and this data is again sent through the medium, then check data for the redundancy, then is this okay to send the data, if it is yes, send it as it is, otherwise reject the data. Same algorithm is used here. Now, how is it detection done? Let us see a couple of examples to identify these erroneous bits. Suppose the sender wants to send the word word. The word is WORLD. The lowercase and uppercase do matter in the ASCII characters. I think you all know this. So I am taking WORLD, all are lowercase. So when you take this ASCII character set, each of these word, each of this character is coded like this, and the following shows the actual bit that is sent. See, what is expected to be sent is this. What is written in bold, this data is what is the equivalent, but what you are sending is slightly different. Let us see. If this is the data that is actually sent, you are expected to send 1111, but the last bit, instead of 1, it's supposed to be 1, and what are you sending? You are actually sending 0. Similarly, the next bit, when you take, you are expected to have 1, but you are sending 0. So 1 is made 0, 1 is, here it is 1. Instead of 1, you are sending 0. 1, you are sending 0. 0, 0, no problem. This 0 is also 0. This 0 is sent as 1. So now what is happening? How is this to be understood? How do you understand this? So that means there is a difference in the data that is expected to be sent and the data which is actually sent, and therefore we can conclude that there is some amount of error that is being present. Next one, let me take another example. This example, suppose the word in this example is received by the receiver without being corrected in transmission. That means as it is, without any error, without any corruption, the data is being sent. So when this is sent like this, the receiver counts the ones in each character and comes up with even number, and you assume that you are going for, most of the times, unless it is specified, we only go for even packed. Unless it is specified, usually it is even packed. So now what is it that you are doing? You are checking each character, W, this is O, R, L, D. This is supposed to be D, this is supposed to be W, O, R, L, D. Now, in the first one, the number of counts, number of ones are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Therefore, the corresponding number of ones in this character, the character, I am not talking about the string, W, O, R, L, D together is a string. I think you know the difference. This is the complete string. In the complete string, I am looking for each character W, O, R, L, and D. So the first one is having 6, so it is even. Second one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, even. 1, 2, 3, 4, so it's even. 1, 2, 3, 4, even. So everything is even. And since you assumed it to be an even parity type of transmission, we say the data is accepted. That means there is no error. These are only simple examples that we are talking about. Next example, I think now you got this. Suppose the word in this example is corrupted during the transmission. One case is without error. Now we are talking that there is error being present. So when there is an error being present, the receiver counts once in each of the character and comes up with different values. In this case, this is W. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it's having 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The second one is 6. This is 5. This is 4. This is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the receiver counts once again the number of ones in each character and comes up with an even and odd numbers. Now what we have is a combination of both, combination of even number of ones as well as odd number of ones. So the receiver knows that the data is corrected, discards them and asks for retransmission. So this is one way. Or where is the problem? Problem is only in the W bit, W character which is having 7, W O R, R which is having now 5. Maybe this can be corrected at bit level. You know how to do bit level manipulation in your microcontroller. This also can be done, bit level connection, and allow it to be transmitted as it is. Since this case is that we are discussing is only a small word consisting of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 characters, you can correct it at the bit level for each character and allow it to be transmitted. But most often this is not the case. You have a long text, a stream of bits coming in 32, 64, 128 bits, and it becomes difficult to check these bits at different levels. So in such case, what we do is, what is the receiver expected to do is, it retransmits the data, sends it back to the sender. Then, another example, I think now you got this. Instead of, it is hit by a burst noise of length A and some bits are corrected. So till now, we were discussing only at the single bit level. You can also have burst of bits. That means a stream of either 8, 16, 32, 64 and so on. So when this number of bits come in the form of a burst, then it becomes difficult for us to make the connection. So in such a case, it checks the parity bits. Some of the bits do not follow the even parity rule and the whole block is discarded. So now here what's happening, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is 3, there is an error here, and here 5, 6, this is 6, this is 4. So when there is the entire block that is having an error, they will it will be sent back for retransmission. And now we are talking about, I think this yesterday we discussed about this two dimensional thing. So this is row, I am just reiterating. This is row wise and rows like this, and this is columns. So decision of parity can be done at the row level or at the vertical level. I have done this in the last class. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that means you should add 1 to make it even. In the second case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, it is odd. Add 1 to make it even. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Already, even number is there. So, there is no need to add an extra bit. So, make that bit as a 0. The last row that we are talking about is of 1, 2, and 3. Since it is odd number of bits, you are adding 1. So, together, okay, this is how it is. Now, let us see this one, column wise. 1, 2, so there is no need to add here. Here I am not adding. 1, 2, 3, so you are adding 1. 1, 2, no need to add. 1, 2, 3, you have added here. Here it is 1, 2, no need. 1, so you added 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, there is no need to add. Now the last one. 1, 2, 3, since this is odd, to make it even, so what is in a nutshell, to make it even parity, we add one bit extra. So this is how this is done. The same thing continued here. So now what happens here is this is zero. What happens in sometimes one error affects two parities. Why is it happening? Let us see. Here in this case, this is row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4. This is column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So we will say row. Row and column is what we generally write. So row 3, row 2, comma 3. Second row, third column. Now 1, 2, 3, 4. If this is also 1, that means this is 1 here. Now because this is 1 here, this is making the column even, but row is odd. So one error is affecting both ways. Had it been 0, this would have become 1. If this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, this would have become 0. So alternate shifting is happening. So when there is error in one case, this error is not only affecting this row, but is also affecting the column. Let me take another example of two errors affecting two parties. So what is happening here? In this case, had this been 0 and this also been 0, then 1, 2, 3, you would have made this as 1. Now here, 1, 1, this is also 1, so there is no need to add here. This is 1, 1 plus 1, 2, 0. So if there is an error in these two, it is affecting this column as well as row. That means it is affecting second row, which column? Second row, third column, and second row, fifth column. Both these are affected because there is an error in two of these cells. Four errors. Like this you can discuss. When there are three errors, three bits are in error, three columns are affected. When there are four errors, two rows and two columns are affected. So this is how we will be discussing these kind of things. Now, what is this two-dimensional parity check that we are talking about? Supposing the original data is like this, and do row-wise and column-wise check. So, what is the data? 1100111. 1100111. I am doing it this way, row wise. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ones are there. So to make it one, to make it even, you added one here. The next data. What is the next data? 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ones are there. To make it 1, we've added 1 here. We've added 1 here. By adding 1, 5 plus 1, it becomes 6. Next data is 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. So what is happening? 1, 2, 3, 4. Already it is even, so you have added only 0. The next data, each data is 4 plus 3, 7. 7 into 4, so 28 bits of data is what you are sending. So the last one being 0101001. So 1, 2 and